Good evening and welcome to our Thanksgiving praise and prayer service. Let's begin by going to God in prayer. Father, as we begin this time of reflection and thanksgiving, as we praise you in song, as we hear your word read aloud and reflect and meditate upon it, as we are joined together in prayer, we address you as our Father, as we should, as you've called us to do, beckoning us into your presence, to come before you boldly with confidence. But we recognize in this moment, as we draw near, that we are in the presence of the Lord God Almighty, the one who is without peer, without equal, the Creator, God, and Lord of all. So high above, so far beyond our comprehension and our ability to understand. And we recognize and profess with our lips that you are on the highest place, that yours is the name that is above all names, that you are holy, that you are in every sense of this word that we use, awesome, that there is no one and none like you. Father, we humble our hearts in your presence. We bow low before you. And as we utter this prayer, words utterly fail us. They fall short as we seek to give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise that is due your holy name and your name alone. All of the honor and majesty that is ascribed to your name, to who you are, the great I am, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. You are all in all. And Father, we praise you for who you are. And we praise you for all that you are to us, and for all that you have done to redeem us and bring us back into relationship with you when we had broken that relationship, when we had rendered harm to the fellowship, the intimate relationship that you created us to have with you from before the beginning of time. And we praise you for all that you've done, that we might praise your name, glorify you, and give you the honor that you deserve in redeeming us and bringing us into a relationship with you through your Son, that through him and by him that we can offer up praise and thanksgiving to your holy name. We ask that at this time that you would bless us as from our homes, while we are separated from one another, we unite our hearts once more in praise and thanksgiving to you. And we ask your blessing upon us in this hour as we sing songs of praise, as we listen to your word, And as we come before your throne and talk to our loving, gracious, merciful, kind, forgiving Heavenly Father, who is God of all, Lord of all, King of kings. Father, we give you praise, honor, and glory, and we pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
To God be the glory, great things he hath done. So loved he the world that he gave us his Son, who yielded his life and atonement for sin, and opened the life gates that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he hath done. Great things he hath taught us, great things he hath done, and great our rejoicing through Jesus the Son. But purer and higher and greater will be our wonder, our transport when Jesus we see. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he hath done.
Philippians chapter 1, verse 3 through 11. I thank my God every time I remember you. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart. For whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share in God's grace with me. God can testify how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless until the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place.
When we all
get to heaven,
what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a sigh.
When we all
get to heaven,
what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day,
Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the tolls of life repay.
When we all
get to heaven,
what a day of rejoicing, that will be.
When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold.
When we all
get to heaven,
what a day of rejoicing
that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Let's go to God in prayer. Father, we come before this evening thanking You for all the great blessings You give in our lives, for all the things we have that we are able to use for just being in this country, Father. We have all these freedoms to do and say and be all anything we want to be. Father, we pray that as we go about this Thanksgiving holiday, that we will not just look at our physical needs and physical needs around us of others, but we will look for their spiritual needs. Father, that we will look in our own lives and see where we need to grow so that we can get closer to You, so that we can know You and know You not just as a being far off in heaven, but Father, know You as a personal God who's there walking beside us day by day, minute by minute, that we can talk to any time and express any of our needs or doubts or desires directly to You. Father, we want to come closer to You. Father, give us that understanding of how we can grow and be your friend and Your servant. Father, help us to get into our Bibles more so we can get closer to You. Spend time in prayer to get closer to You. Spend time, get to know how to serve You in this world. In this world that is full of craziness and scared people who are looking for answers, help us to be able to show them how they can grow closer to You as well, so that we can be a light to them, to show them how to come to You as well. Father, I want to pray for the members of our body here who might not come often, who maybe we haven't seen in a little while. Father, that we will know how to reach them. Father, that not only we will know how to reach them, but that they will also have it on their hearts to be open to You. Be open to hearing from You, be open to hearing from one of our members here to touch them and talk to them and bring them back into Your fold. And Father, we do want to pray for our new Christians they've had this year. We've had quite a few baptisms over this past year of people coming towards You, coming to know You, coming to know the truth of Your word, and know the truth of life in You. Father, for all of our new members, for Vesta and Megan and Don and Mo and John and Tom, Father, they are just such an encouragement to see in this year with all the changes going on, all the restrictions we have, that we still see people who desire to come after You and desire to seek You out. And Father, we pray that as they have begun their journey this year, that they will continue to grow stronger in You. They will continue to look towards You for answers, and that their growth will be their growth will be great. Father, with that, we pray for all of our leaders in this body, everyone who has taken on jobs from our preachers and their job that they've taken on to lead this public worship we have, to be the ones that people call on to find answers And Father, for all their trials that they have trying to be everything for people, as people look to them, that they will have strength to do their work. Father, even more so, we pray for our elders who are charged by you to lead this flock. Father, that they will take that job as seriously as you demand it, that they will look towards the well-being of this congregation, and that they will make all their decisions based on your word alone. Father, we know this has been a trying year for them with all the restrictions, and they have a tremendous job trying to lead us through it. And Father, we know that you are there with them, leading and guiding. Father, we pray for all the deacons in our body who have taken on their tasks, various tasks throughout the year of reaching out, of taking care of the building, of taking care of just various things that they all have to take care of. Father, we ask you to give them strength to be able to fulfill those tasks. And Father, for all the members who aren't either an elder or a preacher or a deacon or anything that's public mentioned, but all those who lead in their own way, lead their families, lead by their example of coming here, lead by their example of reaching out to their friends and families and co-workers. Father, we pray that they will have strength to continue to lead as well. Father, we ask that you would be with us bodies. We look for spiritual growth in this coming year. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon the cross, my sin upon his shoulder. Ashamed, I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished. I will not boast in anything, no gifts, no power, no wisdom. But I will boast in Jesus Christ, his death and resurrection. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot
this I know with all my heart. His wounds have paid my ransom.
James chapter 5, verses 13 through 16. Is any one of you in trouble? He should pray. Is anyone happy? Let him sing songs of praise. If any one of you is sick, he should call the elders of the church to pray over him and anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer offered in faith will make the sick person well. The Lord will raise him up. If he has sinned, he will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous man is powerful and effective.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you
and give you peace.
And give you peace.
And give you peace.
And give you peace. The Lord make his face to shine upon you
and be gracious unto you.
And be gracious. The Lord be gracious, gracious unto you.
It's time for us to give thanks. To give thanks to God for everything that we have. To give thanks for this building we have, the homes we live in, the lives that we have, the partners we have. And to pray for our relationships with each other. It's kind of tough at this time with the coronavirus, but I'm sure we'll be back together soon. We pray that we would continue our halted relationships we had going before, get back to somewhat normal. We pray that we would get to know our new brothers and sisters better, to be able to share our lives with theirs, and to spend time together and enjoy each other's company, catch up on all the things that we've missed since we've been apart. When we think about these things, we also pray for them, those that are on our prayer list. Vesta and Brent with the virus, we pray for their total recovery, that they can be back with us when we get back together. And we pray for our brother Guy and our sister Kristen. We all need prayers, and we don't know how much we need them. We also like to pray for Brendan and his rehab, that it would be going well and he would soon be back to normal. And we pray for Adam and Joanne. Pray for Adam's health and for his strength, for his peace of mind and We thank you for his influence in our congregation. And we pray for our brother Les and his health. Father, as we age, we all have little problems that crop up. And Father, there's so many things that can happen with the when it affects our health, it hits us more where we live. We realize that no one gets off this earth alive. But by knowing you, Father, it makes our lives better. Father, we also would like to pray for King Carol Raines, who are still shut in. They're more or less in isolation at the rest home. And for Donna. Father, we learned a little bit of what it would be like to not be able to see people. But we have not been locked down like they have. We pray for Chuck and Flo McCurdy, Father, in their struggles. They've got a lot of health problems, Father. We pray for their strength and for their well-being. We pray for our sister Fran, her ankle problem, Father. We pray that that would heal and she would be able to get on with her life. There are so many things that can happen to us. We also want to pray for Mary, who's in the hospital with their leg problem. And her husband, Art, is also in for cancer treatments. Pray for his recovery, too, Father, and Mary's. And Father, we pray for Eric for his recovery from skin cancer surgery. There's so many others, Father, that we can remember. We could actually go down and pray for everyone in this congregation, which we do. Father, we realize your blessings and we understand your love. We thank you for your love and your patience, but mostly for your truth, Father, because it's the only place we can come for truth. We pray, Father, that you would put your hand on these that we're praying for and heal them. And we pray for the time when we can come back together and personally talk with them and share our lives with one another as we did in the past. Father, we know that a body that's parts are separated doesn't work very well. We pray, Father, that you'd be with us in this endeavor to have this remote services and prayer. We pray that we might always remember those that are less fortunate than we, and always put others ahead of us. Father, you have taught us the only way to show anybody you care is to show them love. Everyone needs love. We know, Father, the person that least deserves it needs it most. We pray that you'd guide us through this life. Help us to connect with those that need our help. Put them in our ways, Father, so that we can help them any way we can. And be with us, Father, to overcome any imperfections that we have in our dealings with people. Help us to see people through the eyes of Jesus. We pray this in his holy name. Amen.
In Christ alone my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. my comforter, my all in all. Here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save, till on that cross as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay. Light of the world by darkness slain. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
Colossians chapter 1, verse 9 through 27. For this reason, since the day we heard about you, we have not stopped praying for you and asking God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all spiritual wisdom and understanding. And we pray this in order that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and may please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to his glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience, and joyfully giving thanks to the Father, who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the kingdom of light. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For by him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities. All things were created by him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together, and he is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything he might have the supremacy. For God was pleased to have all his fullness dwell in him, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through the shedding of his blood on the cross. Once you were alienated from God and were enemies in your minds because of your evil behavior. But now he has reconciled you by Christ's physical body through death to present you holy in his sight, without blemish and free from accusation, if you continue in your faith, established and firm, not moved from the hope held out in the gospel. This is the gospel that you heard and has been proclaimed to every creature under heaven, and of which I, Paul, have become a servant. Now I rejoice in what was suffered for you, and I fill up in my flesh what is still lacking in regard to Christ's afflictions, for the sake of his body, which is the church. I have become its servant by the commission God gave me to present to you the word of God in its fullness, the mystery that has been kept hidden for ages and generations, but is now disclosed to the saints. To them God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Seeking the lost, yes, kindly entreating, wanderers on the mountain astray, come unto me, his message repeating, words of the Master speaking today.
Going afar
upon the mountain,
bringing the wander
back again.
Into the fold
of my Redeemer,
Jesus the Lamb
for sinners slain. Seeking the lost and pointing to Jesus, souls that are weak and hearts that are sore, leading them forth in ways of salvation, showing the path to life evermore.
Going afar
upon the mountain,
bringing the wander
back again.
Into the fold
of my Redeemer,
Jesus the Lamb
for sinners slain. Thus I would go on missions of mercy, following Christ from day unto day, cheering the faint and raising the fallen, pointing the lost to Jesus the way.
Going afar
upon the mountain,
bringing the wander
back again.
Into the fold
of my Redeemer,
Jesus the Lamb
for sinners slain.
Our God and our Father, at this time of the year when the world around us remembers to stop and give you thanks for all the blessings that you bestow upon us, Father, we ask that we always remember every day to give you the thanks that you so richly deserve. You give us all the material blessings that we need and far more, and all the spiritual blessings that we need. And we thank you for those wonderful blessings. Father, we ask you now that you would help us to remember to share these blessings we have with those round about us as we try to expand the boundaries of your kingdom. We look for numerical growth in this area, and we pray that you would help us to use our abundant material blessings and our skills that you have blessed us with to help to teach others about you and the goodness and the mercy that you've shown us. Father, we pray that we as your children could learn to teach
or do whatever we possibly can to expand the boundaries of your kingdom. There are some who teach or some who can't teach, but Father, we can all be good examples and show others what your goodness and mercy has done for us, and hopefully lead others to come to the same knowledge that we have about Jesus and his saving grace. Father, we're so thankful that you give us all these wonderful blessings, and we ask that we share them with others as we should. You've asked us to. You've been so good to us, we need to be so good to others that we might show your goodness through our efforts. We ask that you be with not only us here in this area to expand the kingdom, but all of our missionaries that we are aware of and have supported in the past throughout the world. Bless them, give them the strength that they need to carry on and do the good works that they do. We ask that you might bless their efforts and show them the kindness of your heart by giving them success in the work that they do. It's through your Son, Jesus, that we pray. Amen.
O thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me ever to adore thee, may I still thy goodness prove. While the hope of endless glory fills my heart with joy and love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, hither by thy help I've come. And I hope by thy good pleasure, safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Oh, to grace how great a debtor daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness like a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee. Never let me wander from thee, never leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy courts above.
Ephesians 3:14-21. For this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom his whole family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the saints to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
It has fallen upon me to come in and close out our Wednesday evening service, our service of thanksgiving and praise for this Wednesday evening. And I find that to be quite a challenge, because when we stop and think about those things that we're thankful for, that God has done for us, the words fall short. There's so much to be thankful for, but yet the words fall short. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bow my head now, and I'm going to give each of you some time to think about all of the things that you are thankful for, and to thank God in prayer for those things. And then in just a moment, I'll lead us together. Let's pray. Our gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we come to you into your presence at this time, and we are so humbled to come before you. But yet, every day is a day of thanksgiving. Every day that we can lift up our voices to you in song and in prayer, and that we can read your word, is a day of blessing and a day of thanksgiving. And Father, we're thankful that in your knowledge, in your foresight, in your understanding, that even before the foundations of the earth were set, you planned our salvation in Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you that you were willing to give your own Son to die such a horrendous death, so that we could live, so that we could come and be with you one day. Father, that's just unfathomable. It's so hard to understand. But yet we know you did. And we thank you. And Father, the blessings that we receive from you each and every day, those blessings that we can't even wrap our minds around. It's not just what you did for us in Jesus Christ. It's what you do for us every day. As you guide us along the way, as you keep our paths straight. Father, we thank you for being our God and our Father, and allowing us to be your people and your children, and for raising us up, Father, to be priests and a kingdom. Father, it's amazing what you've done in our lives. We all know that when we came to you and we put on Christ and we felt what you did in our lives when you lifted us from sin. And as we continue our walk, Father, we go through some problems sometimes, but we know that you're there. And we know that you care. And we know that you lift us up. You've done it again and again and again. And for that, Father, we thank you. We thank you that you don't remember our sins anymore, that they've been washed away, that they've been cleaned, that they've been forgotten. And Father, we want to thank you for your church that you've set up. Thank you for a body of believers that we can be in, for brothers and sisters that love us and care for us and are there for us because of our common love that we have for one another and for you. That we are bound together, Father, in that love. And we thank you that you've created this family. We thank you that you've allowed your Son to be head over this family, Father, to be our big brother, to be our guide, to be the one that we wish to emulate. Thank you for your word that has allowed us to see this life that you've called us to. Father, we thank you that we live in a land where we can come together and worship you freely, even though sometimes it feels like, might be just around the corner that things change, especially at this time when we feel limited. Yet, Father, we realize that we're putting more limitations on ourselves than the government is. And we pray, Father, that you would make sure that the government does not interfere with our service to you. We thank you that you've been holding them at bay. We thank you for the freedom that we have to worship you in spirit and in truth. And may that continue. Father, we pray that you would lift us up this night and throughout the remainder of not just this week, Father, of this month, of this year, but of our walk here on earth, and hold us safe and close in your hands. We thank you ahead of time because we know that's what you do every day. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.